can just summarize that.
No, I want to ask you some questions about this.
Yeah.
Hey, we are back with Lindsay Caron. She's opening up her art show, her first solo art show here at the Talking Stick tonight. And we just took a tour of the art show, and now we're back at the table. We're going to wrap up this segment. And why am I looking over? That should be over here. That would make more sense because that looks all wrong. You guys, it's so hard doing it all. Here we go. We're good. All right. So I pulled down Lindsay's bio because I wanted to ask her a couple of questions. I was really moved by some of this information. But I love that you say, Lindsay Caron is an art activist.
Art activist, yes.
That's awesome. Tell us what an art activist is.
Well, you know what? I got that phrase, actually. It was coined from Creative Visions Foundation. I can't be credited with this phrase. Creative Visions Foundation is a foundation that I discovered this past year, and it's based on the life of Dan Eldon, who was a creative activist. This is what they call him. And basically, he was a Reuters photographer in Africa. He grew up in Africa, and he was killed in Somalia while documenting the war there at age 22. So he lived an incredibly short life, And he was an inspiration to everyone that he met, and just lived his life with so much passion and enthusiasm. And he raised money for a multitude of causes and really just helped out anyone that he met. And he did it with his art. And his life is documented in 22 huge journals full of his collage work. And it's beautiful. It's absolutely beautiful. And Creative Visions Foundation was founded by his mom, Kathy, and his sister, Amy, after his death to commemorate his life and to inspire others to live in his way. And I was just so touched by this organization. It's everything that I want to do with my life. I want to travel the world and break down cultural barriers with art as well. And so huge, huge fan of Dan and fan of Creative Visions Foundation. And I was lucky enough to get to spend some time with them. And so that's where the phrase art activist comes in. And I think it fits what I do pretty well as well as what Creative Visions does. And they now have an organization that supports creative activists. So documentary makers, all sorts of different things. And I'm actually doing some art workshops for kids this summer.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, they're called Draw the Destination. And I'm working with Alex Rose, and he's a local graffiti artist in the Pacific Palisades. And we're going to work with the kids and teach them how to be creative activists, and teach them based on premises that Creative Visions Foundation came up with. And they're just brilliant, absolutely brilliant people. So I'm very excited to share that with kids this summer.
I'll be posting that link on my wall. You guys will have that link.
Definitely. Please, I need to go check that out. We need clients. We need kids' minds to mold.
Well, I got to just say, boy, you just telling me this moved me, because I know a couple of things that you might not know. Because I know that you are going to be 22 here, shortly, soon.
Yeah.
And when you said his age of 22, I made the connection of you are just picking up where he left off. And I think you have the skills, the talents, the ability to do exactly what he was setting forth to. And I sensed it when I read this, that you are an activist. And I pulled down her bio. You have already started raising money.
Yeah, last summer I did a benefit art show because I was really moved by my friend's coworker. He is from Africa, and he founded something called Maka Water for All, and basically is building 40 freshwater wells throughout Cameroon.
Wow.
And I wanted to help him out, so I threw a huge benefit art show. It was my first ever, and it was so much work.
She's so young, crazy. So talented, so great.
And there were 25 artists and four bands, and food and fun and entertainment, and we ended up raising $2,000 to build a well in Cameroon.
That is so awesome.
Yeah, and my friend is actually continuing it this summer in Wisconsin, so if you guys want to check that out.
She's a Wisconsin girl, if you haven't figured it out.
Wisconsin, but now LA.
She's a cheesehead. Are you a cheesehead?
Absolutely. 100%. Go Pack.
Well, that's right. You guys won the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah.
All right. I know. I was glad. I didn't want the Steelers to win. Sorry, Steeler fans. But I'm a New England Patriot fan, so I don't like the Steelers.
Well, I don't like the Patriots.
I know you don't. That's why I'm just refraining from telling you that until the end of the interview. No, okay. This bio is just so wonderful. Lindsay strives to use her creativity to influence those around her, not only comment about the social injustices of the world, but to take action. That is a huge, huge undertaking. I mean, you want your work, your art, to not just inspire people or make people comment, to make people take action.
Yeah.
That's beautiful. I mean, that's beautiful. So you guys watch this girl. I mean, your work, this is so incredible, is just stunning. Just so lucky to meet you and get this personally inside this interview. You are an activist and an artist and a great person. I'm really proud of you.
Thank you.
I'm really proud of you, you know, because you're doing it, you know, and I'm so, thank you for joining me here. Look at that, shaking hands on camera. I don't think I've ever done that with anyone yet, but I did that with you. I'm getting new at this interviewing, hosting stuff. If you guys have a chance to come down to the Talking Stick, how long will your show be hanging? Do you know?
The rest of the month, I think. I'm not exactly sure when the next artist is coming up. He's showing in August, so
yeah.
We'll see when my work gets taken down. But it'll definitely be up for the rest of the month, so come check it out.
So if you're,
it's worth the trip.
Absolutely. If you are in Venice, Santa Monica, Del Mar, L.A., come over to the Talking Stick and come see Lindsay's show in person, because you can't appreciate it. You can't appreciate it the way I tried to, you know, have you appreciate it. You got to come down and touch us in person or see it in person. And if you're lucky, maybe you'll meet Lindsay. And if you do come down, you're going to find me here. So come and say hi to me. And have some great coffee at the Talking Stick and listen to some great music. They do music 7 nights a week here. It's the intersection of a Lincoln and California Street. We're right across from Ralph's and Ross and all that. Come down to the Talking Stick. Come see Lindsay's show and support her. And, you know, keep an eye on her. Lindsay, Karen, I think you're going to be seeing and hearing a lot from her in the future. Thank you so much. Have a great show tonight. We're going to catch her live painting. I will stick around and get some live painting. And we're going to wrap up this episode of TED TV. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.